This portion of the question is asking us to determine what the individual consumer surplus is for each person purchasing a diamond, as well as the total consumer surplus and what the producer surplus will be. We know that in perfect price discrimination situations in Part A that we're going to sell four diamonds, and each person is going to pay their maximum willingness to pay. So for each of the four that are purchasing a diamond, Raquel, Jackie, Joan, and Mia, their consumer surplus is going to be zero. Raquel was willing to pay $400. She does pay $400, so surplus is zero. Same for Jackie, Joan, and Mia. Producer surplus, we can calculate it. For the first one, Raquel is willing to pay $400. It costs $100 to produce, so there's $300 in producer surplus when it comes to Raquel. For producer surplus for Jackie, she's willing to pay $300. It costs $100 to produce the diamond, so there's $200 in producer surplus for her. Producer surplus for Joan, she's willing to pay $200, and that's what she pays. It costs $100 to produce the diamond, so there's $100 in producer surplus. And producer surplus for Mia, she was willing to pay $100. She did pay $100. It costs $100 to produce, so there's zero producer surplus for the diamond sold to Mia. So total producer surplus in this market would be $300 plus $200 plus $100 plus zero. That gives us total producer surplus equal to $600.